learn one more important topic in the sixth class, that is the emergency of kingdoms. Today's our topic is emergency of kingdoms. See, first man started his settled life near the river basin area. Why? Because in the river bank areas, water facilities are there and the soil is good for agriculture. And water also available for their animal, for their animals. So that is why, and it is very good for the navigation to move one place to other place on the water. So that is why first man started settled life near the river banks. So kingdom, before kingdom we have to learn, in our country near the Ganga basin area, Ganga river, it is a very big river originating Himalayas. Okay, Himalayas to Deccan Plateau, this Ganga river will flow, and this Ganga river area, many small kingdoms were established. In 2700 years ago, so many kingdoms were there in the Ganga basin area. So first, people, they started living near the river basin. In a small group of people, they settled in one place. Like a tribals. So that we can call Jana. Jana is people. So near the Ganga basin areas, there are many Janapadas are there. Jana means what? Group of people. That village, that area we can call Janapada. Janapadas. Near the Ganga basin area, Ganga river basin areas, many Janapadas are there. So, total in the river Ganga basin area, 16 Mahajanapadas. 16 Mahajanapadas in this river Ganga basin area. So, what is Mahajanapada? You just keep in mind. First one is Jana. Jana is nothing but some group of people who settled near the river basin area, okay, like a small village, that we can call Jana. So for that place, like a tribal people, how they settled in the forest area, some hilly area, same like that, near the Ganga basin area, different places, some group of people settled, that we can call Jana, that place we can call Janapada. So head of this place, only that village head we can call Grihapati. The head of the village or Janapada, head of the Janapada, Grihapati is the headman. Grihapati is the headman. Here, so this Grihapati having that good land, more land, Grihapati is totally take care of this Janapada, and he is a total responsible person to that village. He only do the judgment. He only take care of food, like he only policeman, and he was the judge, and he also king. Okay, he only dictate all the things in the village, that is the Grihapati. Grihapati is only one person who are having more land. That person will total rule that village. That we can call Janapadas. So there are many Janapadas are there at the time in the year of 2700 years ago in the Ganga basin area, many Janapadas are there. So suppose one Janapada totally is the responsible person to that village to protect from others. This Janapada or Grihapati, head of this village, Grihapati, he is the main headman. He also called like a headman, he is the head or responsible person. So that place, that village, he only decide that total, he give the judgment, he announce the, he only declare the days to celebrate the festivals, and he give the judgment, all the marriages, everything will decide by this Janapada, headman of this Janapadas, headman or Grihapati. And next to these many village people will work in his Grihapati's land freely without any salaries. The village people, they should work in this in his field. Because he is the headman of his village, as his slaves, like his slaves, they have to work in the Janapadas agriculture field. because he is taking care of that village. So that is why the village people and who are not having land, landless people, poor people and slaves also, that people has to work in the Grihapati's land, the headman's land. And sometimes he will give some less price also who are working in the agriculture field. Finally, he is a headman like a king to that village. So Grihapati is a king of that village. And next, if any other countries or any other new people will attack on that places, there are many Janapadas there for them, or Janapadas people together they will fight. Because one Janapadas to other Janapadas, they have very close relation. If any outers will reach that area, so all the village people will together, all the people or all Janapadas people together, they fight on that area. So this is the Janapadas. Next, Mahajanapadas. Just now I told that total are 16 Mahajanapadas are there in the Ganga Basin. So Mahajanapadas is nothing but, so these Janapadas which are there, number of Janapadas under the control of one Mahajanapadas. Janapada, it is like a village. So many Janapadas, large area, many Janapadas ruled by one person or ruled under the control of one person, that is called Mahajanapadas. Okay, in the near the Ganga basin area, total 16 Mahajanapadas are there at the time. Total 16 Mahajanapadas. So that we can call these Sodasha Mahajanapadas. These 16 Mahajanapadas we can call Sodasha Mahajanapadas. So Janapada is like a small village. Mahajanapada is nothing but many villages will come under the one person. So these Mahajanapada head only we can call as a king. Okay, he is the king. These Mahajanapada, many villages, number of Janapadas will come under the one control. One person handle that you can call Mahajanapadas. So in the Ganga basin area, total 16 Mahajanapadas were there at the time in the year of 2017. So these Janapadas we can call Sodasha Mahajanapadas. See, Jana is nothing but a Sanskrit word. Jana means people. Mahajanapadas means large area, many people, large area we can call as Mahajanapadas. And next, so here Mahajanapadas also like a kingdom, because kingdom is the large area which was ruled by a single person, that case we can call that kingdom. A large Magadha kingdom, Mauryan kingdom. So large areas which was ruled by under the control of one person, the large area ruled by one king, that place we can call that kingdom. So republic, the republic is nothing but this is like a independent ruling. Republic, independent ruling. No empire, nothing. These people will rule themselves. That place we can call a republican place. So in the Ganga basin areas, many republic places are known. And already you know that Janapada and Mahajanapadas. So Janapada is everybody is a village head or Grihapati. Mahajanapada is like is a head of that Mahajanapada, king or empire. But how we know all this information? How should we study and how can we get all these information? See, there are the two sources for knowing these people's information. There are two sources. One is that archaeological, one is archaeological site, and second one is writings. Many scholars wrote some books. By that we can study about this Mahajanapadas, Janapadas, Mahajanapadas information. So archaeological site, archaeological is nothing but these people will excavated many places. Many sites they excavated. Archaeological department in India, first like Delhi and Amritsar and Patna, Ayodhya. In many places the archaeological department they excavated many places, and we got many goods like objects which they used at the time. So people got many for lot of things at that place by excavating by archaeological department. By that we are knowing that in the people lifestyle at the time. And many books also written. So many books also written in that time, like Marx, Buddhist monk, Jainist monk, Christians. Many people they wrote a lot of information about this Ganga Valley area, Janapadas and Mahajanapadas story, Mahajanapada information. So by reading the books and by the archaeological science, we are knowing lot of information about these many kingdoms which are there near the Ganga Basin area. So in the Ganga Basin area, many kingdoms are established. First Janapada, then after Mahajanapadas. Okay, Janapadas, Mahajanapadas. So these are the main important thing in this lesson. And remaining, what are the main important kingdoms were there at that place, I will explain in the next class.